appointed you as an ambassador of my kingdom. Would you like to take up the appointment? Would you like to take up the appointment?
That's a privileged position. The government, the everlasting government. Would you like to take up the appointment? Yeah, no, Mubakatulewa.
Kingdom ambassadors, you are here to speak and act on behalf of the government and the king of whites. Kakwa, do you see anything that you have? I don't think it's wow! Osanga ngani kalibi, osanga ngani taki sartika. Hallelujah!
Thank you. Sabe. Kakrame nanga rabo nukule na masu sa masu na tamai kema melo malangi me bakaro koro ta kina adam ni me adam ni muni mate ni tu me dak na loma muni burubura me mi bula me baka sa ba daro tu melo malangi tamai kema me badam bora viki mini na wasa tu mate kema mi ya wo ni me vi so tak vi wo se itang na muni bosa mba mba uta ka bonde itang na muni bosa sa buni bula vi kema mi dusi maka vi kema na sala me kema muria kabuke kima me kem don dingi takana kay don don e matamuni na bale buturanga na nomni loloma nomni yalon dina na silbuni kwa rani me kem be mbula ngodi talen na kene be wase ten muni bosambula na silbuni kon sa sin mbula na tamata na man rein don donga sambula na bos ke venga sa loko me na ngusu muni chobana le mami kalu turanga badam borbi kimni na iretala na baroma na silbuni kwa na bale buna kalu na lotam na ngasini budi deb ko na babul de kima me na kandina parama takina mami sala mikio mkila na sala mikio mmuria sala rambailele sambasi ya kina mbuli na bale buna uongoni ve dingi taka mikio mbronga dana mbosa ve wasi ikine na silibu ni kuwa kimsanga imasu na vabi ni binaka ya na adhamu ninga achisu na karista na mamitura na mamitui ya dhiti nga menimbaga mbula tale indina endu onduwa nga meni tomanda utoro nongo mewe kindaba kibwe kendaba ndundua sara na asema tingoma na Kingdom Facebook TV live na silibu ni kuwa tomanda u pamni binagata na musilo numni ngauna ram ndam vi bulongodi ta vi bulongodi na pata pata vi bulongodi ngona Kingdom TV Facebook na poku ndon donga ni posa ni klu kanda mbauta ni ndakila ni sini bula na tamata na manrain ndon donga sambula na posa kedenga sala ko mena ngusi tsoba non ndabi naka non ndon bula non ta buku kenam dal matua itu ndon donga na posa ni klu ko ngona utoro ngo me wabi binagata na numni semarati ngona na sibulu ni kwa ni taka mbauta ni na vilu ta kena kalolo tambo nonda vi wasi na ya uo vinango ber ni toma nonda le sone silibu ni kuwa o kire rato na dhorobo ni dota na sere na singe lebu vinaga ni kuwa
Thank you.
Nanganda sa tomano sa ratio ng dalis Sony kanda taratio man abis ng lebu bago ito na kingdom positioning, yan na righteousness, the kingdom positioning, may pagka kanda sa daw kilatio there four keys to life, matay one of the greatest tragedy in life is not death, but life without a purpose. Na kani karua, the greatest challenge is in life is to know what to do. The greatest challenge in life is to know what to do, and it is very important for us to prioritize, to know what is the priority in life, in order for us to choose what's the most important thing to do in our life. As we wake up in the morning, there are many options available, there are many activities that should we choose from that are available to us as we wake up in the morning. And out of all this, we should know that which one is the priority in life, which one is the most important thing. And we may have our own opinion on what is important in life. But today, in this lesson, we are going to see life from God's perspectives. And we are going to study what is God's priority in life. Men may have their own view, opinion on the most important thing to life. But according to God, the most important thing is his kingdom. As is mentioned in Matthew 6:33, the Bible says, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you." So one of the greatest challenges in life is to know what to do. So according to Matthew 6:33, from God's perspective, there it boils down to two: the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So according to God, he simplifies life into two: the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Simply as that. All other things are byproduct to this: the kingdom of God and his righteousness. As I've mentioned before, men may have their own opinion on what is the most important thing in life. Some they value education, some they value business, some they value tradition and culture. But according to God, his priority for mankind, as mentioned in Matthew 6:33, is the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So it all boils down to two: the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Simply as that. if we understand and believe that, then life will live a simple life. So in this lesson, kingdom positioning, which deals with righteousness. So every other thing is a byproduct. The Bible says, if we seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things, what we've been looking for, what we'll be searching for, will be added to us. So that makes life simple. We just focus on his kingdom and his righteousness, living right in his kingdom. That's it. Everything is a byproduct, will be added to this. So in this lesson, we'll be focusing on righteousness, maintaining our right standing in the kingdom of God. That makes life simple. Datomana chigoma na bana zabatuki na no talana vutu. When we see our reflection in the world, we respond in one or two ways. Nangauna kenda wilika kina ne volatambu. There are only two responses. Either we read the Bible and we walk away, never take thought of what we have just read or heard. We become this group, they become hearers only, deceiving themselves. That's one group. As I mentioned, there are only two respond regarding with the word of God. Either we hear it and walk away, forgetting what we've just read or heard. They deceive themselves. Or we continue to look intently in the word and to keep the truth it reveals in our heart, our minds, and on our lips. We choose to believe what it says and live our lives like we believe it. We are doers of the word regarding this group. So either you hear us only, deceiving yourself, or you are doer of the word. So to respond. So it is entirely up to us which group should we belong to regarding the word of God when you hear it. Ruangane wasi wasi, dua ngaya ra rongoda ka rongule dhaba, pakai sinira, dua kenda na rongoda, kanda ngay dhakaba. Which benefits our life. Anabano sa me dhaba kina na noa. Today we are going to see what the word of God says about our position in Christ. Kenda na varo ngole bango na vika e tukuna na kalu mimbali tikenda. And on a day two to a matenicalo, and a book you want to rango chisu. O Catale, Silam Nukanda, Navarbi was a kina, Navaca, Navica, Tugunacalo, Mimbaleton on day two. A matenicalo, and a book you want to rango chisu. What the word of God says about our position in Christ. I say it again, we are going to discuss, we're going to learn or study about what the word of God says about our position in Christ. Matai, you are a saint, justified and forgiven of sin, not a sinner. Okatale, you are a saint, justified and forgiven of sin, not a sinner. Membale akenda sabakan donui, enabuguni ngone turango chisu, ndasabo soti, man nonda ibalabalada, kanda sa significa tugai tele mende ibala bala da tele mata nikalu kembali kenda sa pagan donui e mata nikalu kenda sa tundon e mata nikalu not a sinner but a justified saint pagan donui ena mata nikalu kambimbi menda raida kenda mana raya ni kenda sa pagan donui ena bugu ni ngone turango chisu not a sinner but a justified saint. Justified by the blood of Jesus Christ. Kenda sa tundo ne matani kalu. Ena bungu ni wane turango chisu. Vida na tini wala tam meba ande itanga na tikino ngo. Roma lima tini kawalu kina tini kadiwa. Kira mewi lima ndabi kenda na silibu ni kuwa. Roma na kena wase lima tini kawalu kina tini kadiwa.
Okoya ngo mebakasa lewai midhumrubi na tumat kedenga ena bungu ni ndomba unga nadhala. Sapa katalangakina, enabuku nindombo nga na ibalabalan tontonu, sarawa, merabakan tu nui na tamat kedenga merembula. Kami paka sabak dalai na lewunga enanon dalai indre endua mbau na tamata. Sabak donui paka talanga kina na lewunga enobuku nino na tali raro elendua.
Therefore, as through one man's offense, judgment came to all men, resulting in condemnation. Even so, through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. For as by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners, so also by one man's obedience, many will be made righteous.
The free gift came to all men being justified. The free gift came to all men being justified. It's free from God himself to all men, and we are being justified. We have no part in this. It's a free gift. We do not work for it. We do not deserve it, but God gave it as a free gift to us all by being justified through the blood of Jesus Christ. Ya nabe kai tuna na bosini kalu. Do tale Colossians 2 tin karua. Colossians kana wasin 2 tin karua. Colossians 1 verse 12.
Mondo paka pribina ka buana tamanda. O kwa sapa karo teki kenda mentarawa tana kenri botobota. Ersa elso sawa enararama.
Giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light.
We are justified and forgiven. Now, Paul Roma, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification. The free gift came to all men, resulting in justification. Now, Colossa, he has qualified us. We do not do anything to qualify ourselves, but he himself has qualified us. It's very important for us to see us as a justified saint and forgiven. Because the way you see yourself, that's how you're going to live your life. Na renga ko raidi ko tukina, ayo ko nambula taka. So if you see yourself or see myself as a sinner, you'll continue to live a sinful way. If we see ourselves and believe that we are justified and forgiven, then it will empower us, encourage us to live in the righteous way. Na rainga ko raidi ko tukina, se na rainga kenda raidi kenda kina, yanga na nambula kenda nambula taka. So it's very important of our belief system. This word of God must be built up our belief system. And our belief system depends the way of life. And the way of life determines our destiny. So sakabibi menda raidi kenda, that we are justified, saint and forgiven, not a sinner. Kenikarua, you are victorious over sin, not a fearful victims of sin's enticements. Otunatale, you are victorious over sin, not a fearful victims of sin's enticements. That means you are living from a victorious point of view. Jesus Christ has won the battle on Calvary. We are here to take victory in relation to what he has done. But to Natal, he has won the battle on Calvary, and we are here to take victory. We are here to live a victorious life. You are a victorious over sinner, not a fearful victim of sin's enticement. Kabibi mendarai dea ni kenda sanganga oti, and nabuku ni wone turanga chisuna dela na mai kalibari. Ninda lakotu ya nanganga, ninda lakotu ya na belief system that we are victorious. We'll be victorious. If we go into a playground to play a game, and in our mind that we already seen us as victorious, as a winner, we'll exactly be like that. Nimbere ndala gorera ndala gito kepka ndala saridi kenda tu ndala nganga ena buke abakalebu ndala ngelenganga elomani rara. So it's about the battle of the mind. Na ve evoluke ve kuna valuta mandano mbaka sam. If you can win the battle in your mind, you can win whatever battle is there ahead of you. kambimbi menda valuti gwene valuti bakasam menda ganga manda nanda bakasam menda raidikenda ninda nanganga ena nanda bakasam nanda bakananan. So we see ourselves as victorious. Only then it will give us an encouragement and empowerment to win whatever battle that is ahead of us. So as we face each and every day, as we wake up and we see ourselves as victorious, we'll be victorious. We'll overcome whatever temptation that may come across in our life throughout the day. Pagdating ng weekend na Roma na kinawa si ono tin kaba. Tawili ka man na Roma na kinawa si ono tin kaba. Romans chapter 6 verse 24.
Ni sani vitalia ta ki kimdo na ibalbala da. Ni do sa sani lawai ena bunau ena lolo manga.
For sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under law, but under grace.
For sin shall not have dominion over you. Why? Because you are under grace, not under law. If we, on the other hand, if we are under the law, then sin would probably overcome your life. But since we are under grace, since we are under Jesus, we are guaranteed that you will always be victorious in whatever circumstances regarding temptation that come into our life. So we are victorious as we approach each day and whatever come across in our life. Kenekatolu, you are a blessed friend of God, not a stranger he will ignore. You are a blessed friend of God, not a stranger he will ignore. Kentarusa tokani bona kasare bona klu. We are a friend of God. Sengani bulangi. Same lima tin karua. Psalms 5:12.
Misai kemuni tioba ena bakalonga takana arundundunu konina bako voliboliti koya ena loloma me bakana isasambai.
For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous. With favor, you will surround him as with a shield.
Matai, you are a saint, justified and forgiven of a sin, not a sinner. Ken Karua, you are a victorious of a sin, not a fearful victim of sin's enticement. Neken Katolu, you and me are a blessed friend of God, not a stranger he will ignore. And on the two together, namate nikalu, and abugun want to run at you. That's who really we are. Based from God's perspective. There are many things that our friends, our family, our parents may say of us. But this is what the Word of God revealed to us about our true identity in Christ. Let God be true, but every man a liar. Romans 3:3-4. Let God be true, but every man a liar. Ken mbale sakambi bi mendaru bitata na veka enda dau rongo dhatu maybir na wekanda kamenda toribaka semenda dingoma na veka tukuna tikuna kalo mbale tikanda. You are a victorious, you are a blessed friend of God. Dotale, you reign in life through Jesus Christ. You will reign in life through Jesus Christ. You will reign in life. So we are not a loser, we are a winner. We always win in every circumstance they will go through. Whatever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world. It is our faith. We faith in what God says about you, or of you. So we will reign in life through Jesus Christ. Romans 5:17. Roma lima tin kabit me baga di tagabi kenda na tikinango.
Iya kaba kasangu moto na mate ena bukuna na lendua ena telendendeni lendua ena ngai rau rau baka libu daki ve ira sayado vi ir na lolo malibu keni soli soli ni ve baka ndonui merangu moto ena bula ena bukuna na lendua Jesus Cristo.
For if by the one man's offense death reigned through the one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness will reign in the life through the one, Jesus Christ.
The gift of righteousness will reign in life through Jesus Christ. To Natalie, it's the gift of righteousness. If you receive the gift of righteousness, which is Jesus Christ, you will reign in life. Kebaka kwanza uraidi kuti umbeka ni kwanza unrukan rukwa soma na bete ma kwanza sotaba na bi singa sauti ni kuwa today kwenye pola tamu to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose. Dona season ya, dona season ni kuwa kalokani mabuma uta that you'll always reign in life. You have to believe this. That's who you are in Christ. Kake the wrongo na mbali tigo ngori elasu. Na bi kake de tune ni bola tam tune tio na mbaga sama mbaleta na mbali tiko ngori las vingo mongo ni kandila that you will reign life through Jesus Christ. If you believe this, you have to believe this in order to overcome every temptation that will come through your life from now onwards. You must and you have to see yourself as a victorious person, as an overcomer, as the one who reign life whatever come across. Kada bola tam 1 Corinthians 10:13, no over temptation has overtaken men, but such as common to men. But God is faithful. God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able. But with the temptation, He make the way, He provide the way for you to escape from the temptation. Do not tell him that He is faithful. He will provide the way out of it. Abi kenda na silim nukwa. Sakambi bi menda vambota na biti nongo. It builds out our life. It will encourage you, edify you. And this is your true identity in Christ, that from now on today, you have to confess and believe that you will reign in life through the one Jesus Christ. Kenikalima, you are a beloved child of God, not one who disappoints Him. You are a beloved child of God, not one who disappoints Him. Kendaru lube nikalo kweba maringeti. Daru salue mandani kalu ndarangi ba marangeti mai wana kalu. Kalu mani mai bi koya. Kan daru nasiga ni ba mandu atai koya. Sia kota mai ndona ka me ronga da kina na adana. Ken daru na kota tu mai na itugu tu na be kai na ronga bina kina na adani non daru kalu. So you and me are a beloved child of God. Not one who disappoints Him. Kan bi bimen daru diri ken dani kuani ken daru lube ni kalu. Na so me pakau tu na otina na renga ko raidi kuti ukina. If you believe and see yourself as the child of God, you will live like a child of God. It'll shape up your life because your belief system determines how you respond and live your life. I say it again, your belief system, your mindset will determine how you live your life. And your belief system comes from two sources, either from the world or from heaven. Either from Satan or from God. Either the word of the world or word of God. So you choose which of these two sources should you listen to build up your belief system, which determines the way of where you live your life. So if we accept God's word to be our belief system, then that determines the way of life. So Nabika sa lista kitigona silbu ni kwa Nabika tigona kalu. We are a blessed friend of God. We will reign in life. We'll be victorious. You are a child of God. So we are going to form that as our belief system. And from now on, from the 3rd of March 2023, it'll be a different story together. Because you choose to put away all those false information, what people say, what their opinion about you, and take on God's truth about you, identity Christ, that you are a blessed friend of God. You will reign in life. We will be victorious. And you are a beloved child of God, not one disappointed. Psalms 146:8. Same. Don't know what's up, Kawano. Take me one.
Samba suka na matan na matamboko kotiova. Sabakotun donu takira er sabak. Wakali roro kotioba. Salomani irnael dudon kotioba.
The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous.
The Lord opens the eyes of the blind, raises up those who are bowed down, and love the righteous. So he loves you and me because we are made righteous by the blood of Jesus Christ. So he loves us with an everlasting love, more than we deserve, greater than we imagine. That is the love of God. We cannot turn on the sibling kua. Kaupola, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Anafika utuna pola. Sindona kaina tawasi kenda. Maina lolomani kalo inabuku ni wane turanga chisu. Tunoko, for I am persuaded, Ramosiwal, that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things to come, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus. Sin dota naka na yadongo, sin as my muris na vekana gay bulitale, metawase kendaru, my naloloma nikalo. Listen, you are righteous whether you feel like it or not. Otuntale, you are righteous whether you feel like it or not. Go singa walenga niko nikako bakila. Go ndonaka endina etuguna na vosa nikalo. It's not by our feeling. It's the truth of God's word that should be established in our mind. It's not about emotion or feelings. It's the truth of God's word, which is has to be established in our mind. Emotions and feelings just comes and goes. They are just chemical reaction that happens in our body. And they are temporary. But this is the truth of God's word. The truth and donaka and dina nikua, and dina sign mataka, can be tambaya baksa tumain, sinran lasu. Emotions are feeling are temporary. They are just chemical reaction occurs in our body. And after some time it disappears and gone. But God's truth remains forever. So we are righteous. We have to believe this. That we are righteous. Tongo leba saratala ni dona subtopic clothed in righteousness. A simple definition of clothing is items that are to be worn. You can have a closet full of clothing, but unless you put them on and wear them, there are no benefit to you. Redisine tu no mukato na esulu kevakandaru na senindara na sinianga bekendaru. Throughout the Bible, righteousness is symbolized by clothing, especially a robe. In Ebola Tambu, na righteousness and the Vio Kadibola Kasarakin robe. Robe signifies. Se bakata kilgilataka na robe. E bakata kilgilataka na righteousness. So we are given a robe of righteousness. So we have to make a decision to wear it. So we can hear that we are righteous. God has made it righteous. But unless and until that you believe that you are righteous, then it's no use. Just like the clothes. You might have a clothes that he owns it. But unless you choose to wear it, then that clothes is no use to you. Just like the righteousness of God that is freely available to all men. Unless we receive it and believe it, then it will benefit us. Although it belongs to us, though it for us, but it's you and me that are going to make a deliberate choice, a decision today, that we take on the robe of righteousness and face life in the belief, in the confidence that we are righteous before God. Psalms 132, verse 9. Same, don't tikine viwa. 2:9.
Merapa ke sul ena londondonu ko erna nomu ni mbete. Kakakaila ena reki ko ersa nomu ni tamata el sofsoba.
Let your priest be clothed with righteousness and let your saints shout for joy.
Let your priest be clothed in righteousness. Let your priest be clothed in righteousness. Revelation 9:5-9-10. He has redeemed us out of every tribe, tongue, people, and nation, and have made us kings and priests to our God, and we shall reign on them. So we've made You've been made kings and priests. Bible says the righteous, the royal priests, they were the righteousness, the robe of God, robe of righteousness. So since we are priests to God, then we are righteous before him. As believers, we are considered royal priesthood. As believers, we are considered royal priesthood. So we are a beloved child of God. We are victorious. We are more than conqueror. We are born an overcomer. We are blessed friend of God. We are victorious. We are justified saint, not a sinner. And we are royal priesthood. That's the truth of God's word regarding our identity in Christ. That we are royal priesthood. 1 Peter 2, 9 to 10. Rani wili mandana 9 to 10. 1 Peter 2, 9 to 10. Mateni Peter rua ziwa kinatini. 1 Peter 2, 9 to 10.
Ia koi ke mundo na tamatama tendingi taki. Amata mbete baka turanga. Amata nitu yal sosawa. Atamata sato kena na kalu. Mundo baka ritaka kina nona pinaka. Saro koi sakadi wiki mundo. Mana butu-butu kena rama ena viva kurumu itaki. Oi kem do kasengani tamata tau kena eliu yang do sanggai tamata ni kalu. Do asengani lomani eliu yang do sanggai lomani.
But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who calls you out of darkness and into his marvelous light, who once were not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy.
But you are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people. Then you may proclaim the praises of calling out of darkness, who once were not a people, but now a people of God, who have not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Kanevolatam, who once were not a people, but are now a people of God, who have not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. So it's the now word that you are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation, his own special people, chosen by God to live such time like this and obtain mercy from him. Anabeka endina membaleta na tukuna na posi nikalu membaleti kena. Anonde tutu emata nikalu as a result of being justified by the blood of Jesus Christ. What a good news that we are justified. We're beloved children of God. We're a royal priesthood, his own special people. We have obtained mercy and chosen by God to live at such time like this, to proclaim his goodness and to live a life that is correspond regarding that we are citizens of his kingdom. And abu gini wibosaya, kirirto na dharbori ndo na sere, me dapat kita berikan dengan biwasi yang sing lagu ini ku.
Di bintang keturunan.
ngarabanukulena masu sa masu na tamai kima melo malangi kima mi ndua bate na bato tutu sani sere na silebu ni kuwa ni kima mi sabaran donu ya na bunguni gona iturango chisu kima kumba utaka kila ni kima sa ndolu tuye matamuni senga na bunguni mami takadaka na bunguni sulu sulu walenga na bunguni gona iturango chisu kwa ngono ngoko kima sabamba uta ni kima mi nambula nganga tiwe na vya sakete ka nimbula tike ni bunguni kuwa kalako yani loloma lebu ni kaluko tamanda kena ndonu bibaka dhingu ina kaluna olotamu kene sulu sulu bibaka ndonui saadu na bugu ni ngone turanga chisu me sene imami tigo ni singo ngo kene bi singi vini mbula kone kila sabo turanga chisu mekakua ya mekakua saranga ni mundu emeni minaka maithaba tigo bikenda nonda ulibola tamu na sibu ni kuwa meathaba nonda gai veru rongo ditoma tali meathaba nonga na ya nipaka dhingu ni kalonga tasaka chiku na wali